Hi YouTube, so I wanted to come on here and share a card that I made really quick and also to answer some questions I've had about QR codes. This is a QR code that I use in my scrapbooking. Real quick, I'm just going to share the card that I made for my friend Patty. I used my Simon Says bow die to make this little bow because I'm going to hand deliver it. It's not going to go through the mail and it's for Patty, and I used my Milo's ABCs. I love this ABC set from Lawn Fawn. And the inside of the card is, I actually got this card idea from my Creative Time Emma. She had posted this, I think, like 6 months ago, but she used a different camera stamp. But I just reused the camera stamp over and over with my, these little inks that I got from, what are they? I think they're Hero Arts. The Tide Pool, Orange Soda, Butter Bar, and Soft Granite. I thought those colors look really pretty in summery. And this is actually a little die from, my Creative Time, it's a little tab die, and the smile is made from an Amy R stamp set that I had. Just some twine, I hot glued a wood veneer on there and put some enamel dots on the camera lenses. This is October Afternoon Moodway paper, and on the inside I just kind of did a little cluster here with a gray camera and an orange brad, and it says, Sunny Smiles Just For You, for Patty. And so, and I stamped it on the back with my little wiener dog, so that's going to go to her tomorrow. I'm going to buy her some flowers. She's just been having a hard time, and so that card's going to go to her. And so really quick, how I do the QR codes, I know there's a lot of debate. This is what a QR code is. You can scan it. I think the best, easiest, fastest way to do QR codes is if you have an iPhone, because when you have an iPhone, you can video your video. You send it right to YouTube from your video. I have two YouTube channels. One is, they're both public. They both have to be public. And to get a QR code, it has to be a public video so that you can get the information off of that video. And so I have two channels. One is my Weave Monster channel, which is just for my scrapbooking people. The other one is nobody really knows about. It's just another channel that I have, just my small little clips, video clips for. That's why you'll never see these videos on my Weave Monster channel, because it's on my other channel. So the easiest way to tell you how to do QR codes is to go to this. This is what I leave hanging in my desk. It's QR Codes for Scrapbooking Tutorial by Mercy Tierra. She did, this is the exact name of the video. If you want to pause it here and write it down, it's QR Codes for Scrapbooking Tutorial. And her channel is Mercy Tierra. I'm sure everybody knows who Mercy Tierra is. And she has the easiest way to do your QR codes. And so I'm not going to redo everything that she did, because you can just go there. And I don't know how to link videos. So if you want to know how to do it, this is how you do it. Go check out her channel. She's awesome. And there's a lot of debate as to whether, oh, the QR codes might expire, or, oh, that's not going to last for long. You know, that's, you put so much time and effort into doing it, but, you know, you may not have that video 20 years from now. You know what? It only takes me a few seconds. This is a video of my nephew doing, I maybe taped like 1 minute of him doing his little solo for his school recital, and you know what? It was on my phone. I wanted to get off my phone, so I put it on my other channel, and then I was able to make a QR code. This is just type printer paper from my printer, and I slap it on there, and I think it looks pretty cute too. So if it's not able to do the video anymore, then that's okay. I think it still looks cute on there. So I'm going to take my chances as if the QR codes are going to last or not, because I'm sure that CDs may not last, or even zip drives, or even the memory sticks that you stick in there. There's going to be other ways that data is going to be recorded. So that's kind of my feelings on it. So as long as I don't spend too much time doing a QR code and just takes me a minute to put a video in there, we're going to enjoy it for the next few years while it's there. And who knows? I don't think YouTube's ever going to go away. I mean, maybe YouTube will go away, but you do have to upload it to YouTube. It has to be public, and you have to leave it public for it to work on your scan, your QR code. So anyways, that's my take on that. So I hope that helps everybody out. If you just want to write this down and go check out her channel, I don't need to check it out anymore. I used to go back to her channel every now and then to remember how to do it. Now I just have it in my favorites, and I know how to do the QR code like in 30 seconds, and I have a QR code printed out ready to go. So the best way is if you have an iPhone. At least for me, that's the best, easiest way, is an iPhone. So anyways, okay, thanks for watching.